Good evening, and welcome to St. Paul the Apostle Parish. Our celebrant today is Father Mark, assisted by Deacon John. Today is the fifth Sunday of Easter. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life, and he is present to us in word and sacrament. Let us take a moment to reflect on this great mystery. Please stand and join in our opening hymn, number 164, Alleluia, Love is Alive, number 164.
People of God, see the morning is new. Rise from your sleeping and run to the tomb. Come and see, he is alive. Grave that is empty, a promise fulfilled. God who was with us is here with us till he is here. He is here, he is alive. Alleluia, love is alive. Conquered the grave and defeated the night. Alleluia, love is alive. The sun has arisen for all.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you are the way that leads to life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the truth that sets us free. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the source of true life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High Jesus Christ. And the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, constantly accomplish the Paschal mystery within us, that those you were pleased to make new in holy baptism may, under your protective care, bear much fruit and come to the joys of life eternal. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. As the number of disciples continued to grow, and the Hellenists complained against the Hebrews because their widows were being neglected in the daily distribution. So the 12 called together the community of the disciples and said, "It is not right for us to neglect the word of God to serve at table. Brothers, select from among you 7 reputable men, filled with the Spirit and wisdom, whom we shall appoint to this task, whereas we shall devote ourselves to prayer and to the ministry of the word." The proposal was accepted to the whole community. So they chose Stephen, a man filled with faith and the Holy Spirit. Also Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicholas of Antioch, a convert to Judaism. They presented these men to the apostles, who prayed and laid hands on them. The word of God continued to spread, and the number of disciples in Jerusalem increased greatly. Even a large group of priests were becoming obedient to the faith. The word of the Lord.
As we place our trust in you,
Lord, let your mercy be on us. As we place our trust in you,
exalt you just in the Lord, praise him, the Lord, upright and fitting. Give thanks to the Lord on the harp, with the 10-stringed lyre, chant his praises.
Lord, let your mercy be on us, as we place our trust in you.
Upright is the word of the Lord, and all his works are trustworthy. He loves justice and right. Of the kindness of the Lord, the earth is full.
Lord, let your mercy be on us, as we place our trust in you.
See, the eyes of the Lord are upon those who fear him, upon those who hope for his kindness, to deliver them from death and preserve them in spite of famine.
Lord, let your mercy be on us, as we place our trust in you.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, come to him, a living stone, rejected by human beings, but chosen and precious in the sight of God. And like living stones, let yourselves be built into a spiritual house, to be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices, acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For it says in Scripture, "Behold, I am laying a stone in Zion, a cornerstone, chosen and precious, and whoever believes in it shall not be put to shame. Therefore, its value is for you who have faith. But for those without faith, the stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone, and a stone that will make people stumble, and a rock that will make them fall. They stumble by disobeying the word, as is their destiny. You are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people of his own, so that you may announce the praises of him who called you out of darkness and into this wonderful light." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Lifted by his gospel, worthy and well named the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
accepts us, O Lord. No one comes to the Father except through me. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, then you will also know my Father. From now on, you do know him and have seen him." Philip said to him, "Master, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us." Jesus said to him, "Have I been with you for so long a time, and you still do not know me, Philip? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, 'Show us the Father'? Do you not believe that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me? The words that I speak to you, I do not speak on my own. The Father who dwells in me is doing his works. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me. Or else believe because of the works themselves. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes in me will do the works that I do, and will do greater ones than these, because I am going to the Father." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So, good evening, brothers and sisters, and to our brothers and sisters who are watching us on our YouTube channel. It's great to be with you. Beautiful day today, isn't it? I'm moving a little slow. I was trying to do some work out in the garden. You know how that is? But it's good. It's a good change of pace here. There were three things that Father mentioned, three images or three metaphors that Father talked about last week. Do you remember what those metaphors or things were? Anybody remember? Like one, sheep. He talked about sheep, how Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world, and that we too are sheep, you know. We are the sheep of his pasture. You know, he leads us besides verdant pastures and besides still waters, and so we're sheep. And then he said that Jesus is the good shepherd, and so Jesus is surely he leads us, you know, to those places to give us life. And he said we can be the sheep, we can be the shepherd. But what is the third one? He said Jesus is the gate. You know, that it tells us in the reading, it says, whoever enters through me will be saved. And so Jesus, you know, what's funny in John's gospel is he's always referring to him as I am. I am the light of the world. I am the good shepherd. I am the vine and you are the branches. You know, we have all of these I am statements. So today's gospel is very similar to that gospel. Here we have John chapter 14. Most of the time we hear this gospel if we're at funerals. You know, Father said he's glad he didn't have to preach because he's preached this in funerals all the time. So, but it's really a neat gospel, and it's really Jesus at the Last Supper. And he's telling his followers, his disciples, really the 12 there at the Last Supper, that he's going to be leaving. And he says, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. If you have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. I'm going to go prepare a place for you so that where I am, you also might be." And then he says to all of them, he says, "Where I'm going, you know the way." And what has Thomas said? Thomas is always the honest one. None of them knew where he was going. But Thomas was the one that says, he spoke up and he said, Lord, we don't know where you're going. How can we know the way? You know, he said what the others were probably thinking. And then Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And no one comes to the Father except through me. And they probably still didn't understand exactly what that meant. But Jesus was making it clear that really it's a statement of exclusivity. He's the gate. Father told us he's the gate. There's only one way through. You have to go through the gate. That's Jesus. He's the way. He's the way that leads to life and truth. He's not a way. He is the way, right? And so that's so important. But really, the disciples probably didn't understand that fully until after Pentecost. And during this Easter season, we've been reading a lot from the Acts of the Apostles, which tells us what happened at Pentecost and after. Really, it's this transition of the church, this transition of this small band of followers of Jesus being transformed into the body of Christ, the church. And if we, during the daily Mass, we get many more of them, but on the Sundays, we've been reading. And we know that when after Pentecost, when the Holy Spirit came upon the apostles and the disciples, said there were 120 gathered in that upper room. The apostles, disciples, even women. Mary was there and other women were there as well. And they were transformed. Something changed in that upper room. And they now could understand clearly what Jesus was trying to tell them. And so for the last couple of weeks, we've been hearing that first sermon of St. Peter, which we find in Acts chapter 2. And he goes out into the street and he begins to preach the gospel. He preaches what we call the kerygma, the core, the kernel of our faith. And what is the kernel of our faith? It's that, you know, we're separated from God by sin. Jesus came to bring fill that gap between God and us. And he did that by dying on the cross and so that we could have forgiveness of sin. And he defeated even death by his resurrection. And so St. Peter tells those people in Jerusalem who are gathered together, he begins to preach the gospel to them. And he doesn't do it in a nice, easy way. He says, this Jesus who you condemned and crucified is now alive. And what did they say? It said they were cut to the core. They were convicted of their sin. And we too were part of that. Our sin put Jesus on the cross. And so we too at times may need to be convicted of that. And they said, what shall we do? What can we do to be saved? And St. Peter says to them, you gotta believe. You have to repent. And you have to be baptized. And what did it say? It said 3,000 were added that day. You know, it wasn't a nice little cuddly homily that he gave. He actually accused them and he convicted. It was actually the Holy Spirit that convicted their hearts. And they were transformed. And they were baptized. That must have been one interesting baptism to see 3,000 baptized in the streets of Jerusalem that day. And so we have that. So what has happened, you know, how did the church kind of come out of that? Well, we know from a few weeks ago, after Peter preached that homily and it said 3,000 were added that day, right after that it says that they, being those who were baptized and those who were following Jesus, it said they devoted themselves to the teaching of the apostles, to communal life, to prayer, and to breaking of the bread, Eucharist. And it also said that they were in awe of what they were seeing because through the hands of the apostles, there were wonderful signs. People were being healed. There were miracles that happened. And it said that many were added to their number and they began to grow. And so we have today's gospel or today's the reading from the Acts of the Apostles. that reading that we had a couple weeks ago that said that they shared all things in common. Well, you know, as the community began to grow, there began to be problems within the community. And one of the crisis moments was when some of the Hellenists, they were Greek-speaking Christians. They were Greeks who converted to Judaism, who became Christians. They were complaining because their widows weren't being taken care of. And so the apostles said, you know, our job is to teach and to do Eucharist. And so we don't have time to fix these problems. And so they kind of got together and they asked the Holy Spirit to give them guidance. And they decided to bring in some people that could begin to bring that healing and make sure that those people were all taken care of. We call that kind of the calling of the first deacons in the church. And so they asked the people, which is kind of neat. They didn't decide on their own. They asked the people who they wanted to fill those positions. And they chose seven men of reputable, a good reputation, who were filled with wisdom in the Holy Spirit. And so the apostles and the people agreed, these are the ones that we want to have. And you heard the names, Stephen and Nicanor and Philip and Procurus and all those others. And they laid hands on them, and they were the first deacons. And so we deacons are kind of part of that line. But what happened then, it's that kind of took care of the problems of within that community. And it said that the people rejoiced, and the numbers increased even more. And what it said that many came to salvation, even the priests. The priests were the Jewish leaders who conducted the Jewish services. These were the people who were the religious leaders of their day. And many of them came to believe in Jesus. So that was a big movement that happened at that time. And so we see the Holy Spirit working throughout the ages. And he continues to work today. How can what can we gather from these readings that can help us to be really the living word, to be examples of what Jesus wanted to do in the world? And so St. Peter tells us, he says that we are to be like living stones, being built up into a spiritual edifice or spiritual home, to give spiritual sacrifice. So we're not just people here gathering. We're not just followers of Jesus, but we are these living stones. We are the body of Christ. And as the body of Christ, our mission is the mission of Jesus. That is to bring the good news into the world, that God loves them and God wants the best for them, and to call those people to that repentance that God wants for us, so that they can receive the Holy Spirit in their lives. So how can we participate in this mission of Jesus Christ in the world? Well, the church tells us that there's about four ways that are really important. One is just by being good examples of Christians. So when people see us, they say, oh, those people go to church and they have such a nice family and they're kind and they are friendly people. So that's, you know, one way that we can do it, just by our example. Don't they have such nice children, you know? The second one is these works of mercy, the corporal and spiritual works of mercy, you know, to care for the poor, to give food to the hungry and drink to the thirsty and all these different, and the spiritual ones to teach the those who need to be taught. And then the third one of these things is they call it the restoration of the temporal order. It's to bring about a change in society. You know, when we see the world, we see that it's broken. Even here in Joliet, you know, the garden spot of America, that we see brokenness even here in Joliet. And as Christians, part of our duty is to bring restoration, to bring that transformation. And so we need to be involved in the community. I know many of you are in various ways, to bring about, to transform it into the way that God wants it to be. But the fourth one is important too, even though we don't like to do this all the time. It's to share our faith, to share with others what God has done for us. Because sometimes we just feel like we don't know how to do that. But one of the best ways we can do it is just to say, you know, I met Jesus and he changed my life. You know, people can argue with our theology, they can argue with other things, but they can't argue with our experience. To say it, I met Jesus and I now have more peace, I now have more joy in my life. I experience the love of God on a regular basis. Plus, you can invite them. Remember, Pentecost, wear red. Invite somebody to come with you. Spend some time with them. Those are good ways that we can share with others. We don't need to know, you know, the Bible thoroughly. We don't need to know the catechism thoroughly. We just need to tell people what God has done for us. And I know that he's touched many of your lives. And so their charge is to be what we're called to be the living stones, the body of Christ. And I'm going to close with this. This was from the reading that we heard from Peter. You are a chosen race, a holy people, a holy nation, a royal priesthood, a people of his own, so that you may announce the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. Amen.
I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Confident of God's unconditional love, we pray for our own needs, those of the church and those of the whole world.
For bishops, priests, and deacons, that they show the way to God by word and example, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders and citizens of the world's nations, that they serve as good stewards of the earth's resources, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the faithful and for those in need, especially the most vulnerable, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish and diocese, that every heart be filled with the joy of the risen Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, especially Patty Gimble, that they receive the healing power of the Holy Spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Julian Lonzo Minato and Louis Glavin Sr., that they may experience the fullness of God's love in the heavenly kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those on our parish prayer list, for the intentions written in our book of prayers, and for those prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the intention of this Mass, George H. Buck, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Eternal and almighty God, you have loved us without limit. Listen to our prayer through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Please help us sing the presentation song, number 619, Come to the Water, number 619.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands.
O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Heaven and earth.
Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna,
Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. You have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Ronald, our Bishop, Daniel, our retired bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace with you, John.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Please help us sing the communion song, number 441, O God, You Search Me, number 441.
Maker and keeper of my day.
casting and my rising. You discern my purpose from afar, and with love everlasting you beseech me. In every moment of life or death you are. Before a word is on my tongue, Lord, you have known its meaning through and through. You are with me beyond my understanding, God of my present, my past, and future too. Although your spirit is upon me, still I search for shelter from your light. There is no more wonder that can escape you. Even the darkness is radiant in your sight. For you created me and shaped me, gave me life within my mother's womb. For the wonder of who I am, I praise you. Safe in your hands, all creation is made new.
As we begin this new month of May, I'm wondering if we have any May birthdays out there. If May is your birthday month, please stand. This also goes out to anyone who's watching at home on YouTube who may be celebrating a birthday this month as well. Please join me in a blessing. May Almighty God bless all those who are celebrating their birthday in the month of May. May this be a time to continually unfold those gifts that God has given to you in your life. And may Almighty God bless you on your birthday. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Happy birthday. How about May wedding anniversaries? This should be big, right? May. Not as many as I thought. Was it May always like the big wedding month? We got a few, but I expected so many more in May. I don't know why. All right. October, by the way, October is becoming a big month for weddings. I've noticed that in the last 10 years. But we have some May weddings, and we might have some at home on YouTube as well. Please join me in a blessing. May Almighty God bless those who are celebrating their wedding anniversary this month of May. May you continually unfold that gift of married love in your hearts and be a sign and symbol of God's love to his people. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Happy anniversary. Happy anniversary to those home on YouTube as well. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. And I think we have a couple of announcements this weekend. Yes, we have Samaritan Sunday coming up. St. Paul's will be holding a diaper collection during the weekends of May 13th and May 20th to celebrate Mother's Day. All of these donations will be given to the United Way of Will County Diaper Depot, which provides free baby essentials to families facing hardships. We thank you in advance for your generosity. And just as a reminder, again, Deacon John mentioned it so nicely in his homily, but we got Pentecost coming up at the end of the month. You know the challenge. I laid it out very, very succinctly last week. Wear red. Invite one person to Mass with you. Fellowship with them. Take them to breakfast. Take them golfing or bowling or whatever. Spend some time with them. Have some fun. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Let us end this time of worship and praise by singing number 739, Lead Me, Lord, number 739.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, longing for their Lord, for God's coming kingdom shall be theirs. Blessed are the sorrowing, for they shall be consoled, and the meek shall come to rule the world.
Lead me, Lord, lead me, Lord.
Lord, and lead me, Lord, today.